today, as you know, is Foreign Minister of the Federal Republic of Germany, Foreign Minister Genscher.
Will you have a summit meeting this year, Mr. President?
No question for the board.
No answer.
Are you going to let the files go over to the committee? Are you going to cooperate with that committee?
Well, we have to. FBI investigation, both cooperated.
And you know, every time today, I'll tell you this, every time the day that we start with a meeting with congressional leaders, I am behind schedule for the rest of the day.
That's never happened in the cabinet before.
That's when I tell you, you're awfully brave. I get scared to death of things like that because our first child, we were a horse show. Nancy, no, it didn't happen there, but Nancy, being a daughter's doctor, the doctor told her when I was doing, it just was not going to happen a month ahead of time, but it did. I can't dispute that. Not in this country.
How you doing, Jerry? Good to see you. Mr. President, good to meet you, sir.
Good to see you.
California.
Well,
I served 8 years on your board. Eric Culver.
Yes.
Oh, God.
The Oval Office was in the state is visiting. Something. It'll take two or three waves like this coming in while we sit there and can't begin talking business till lately. And the former Vice President of Japan before this one was here visiting. He was sitting in there just absolutely spellbound. And I didn't find out why until after they went, it was all over, and then he told me he was counting the Japanese cabinets. I guess the doors are closed or we're alone at last. Well, friend Vice President over there has joined us. Well, I want to welcome you all to the White House, and first let me say thank you for all that you're doing in the fight to restore voluntary school prayer. I think we're close to victory if we all pull together. On Thursday, the full Senate Judiciary Committee has scheduled a markup session on the voluntary prayer amendment, and the vote will undoubtedly be very close. I know you're aware that Senator Orrin Hatch, who supports my amendment, has also put forth as a possible alternative a silent prayer amendment. Frankly, I don't believe we've been fighting this battle for the right to remain silent. And Senator Hatch, my friend and yours, he does have a valid point, though, about the need to change the original wording of our amendment. The Senate hearings and the communication that I've received from many leaders have convinced me that we can unite all supporters of school prayer only if we can end the fears that government officials will be drafting prayers for the school children. Therefore, I've asked the chairman of the Senate Judiciary Committee, Senator Thurman, Senator Hatch, and other supporters of voluntary school prayer to revise the amendment that they've submitted at my request for the past 2 years now. And I'm requesting that at the end of the second sentence, we add these words, "Nor shall the United States or any state compose the words of any prayer to be said in public schools. This would solve the sticky problem of straight drafted prayers without endangering currently acceptable and praiseworthy practices such as inviting clergy to offer invocations at high school graduations and so forth. As revised, our amendment will assure the constitutionality of voluntary student religious groups, children voluntarily saying grace before meals, voluntary devotional periods, and silent prayer periods. And this is still a local option amendment. Each state and local jurisdiction would still have the right to permit spoken prayer, silent prayer, or no periods for prayer at all. Federal courts would have to stay out of regulating local decisions except to make sure that no one could be required to participate in prayer and that the government could not draft prayer for use in public schools. And I need your help to pass this badly needed amendment. If things go as I hope, we can convince a majority of the Senate Judiciary Committee to pass our revised amendment this week. Then we could aim for full Senate passage in the fall, getting a vote in the House of Representatives early next year. The first step, though, is winning in the Senate Judiciary Committee this week, and I know that you can help there. And now I know that my time.
Mr. President, this is Junior Miss of America.
Hello there.
Hi, nice to meet you.
And I meet a wonderful family in Alabama, sir. She loves you, and I know you're going to love all of them. This is her mother.
Oh, hello. So nice to meet you.
And your sister, Allison.
It's nice to meet you.
Yes, and Jim Ashmore, who was a basketball player for a long time.
Do you remember coming to our house years ago?
I sure do.
You were still governor.
Please. I will.
I will. Thank you.
Yes.
I have something for Mrs. Reagan and for you. A blouse at my Sunday school teacher made for
home. Let me get this straight. That's for me or for
me? I really do respect you. I think you're a fine Christian man. You have the people's best interest at heart. And I want you to know that I visited several conventions and things, the Key Club Convention, the young people, and the junior misses. And I recently went to the American Academy Achievement, where a lot of outstanding youth, and they're all so supportive of you. And we're the voting age now, so I
thank you very much. And congratulations, incidentally. What you... this is good. I know they're going to have some chores for you now. But I hope they'll all be pleasant ones. And I thank you for what you said, and thank you for these.
You make sure she gets that. <It's
you. laughs> Yes. I bet that's in that guy. And I thank
it's
you
different
very much.
For me.
I want to tell you this, Mr. President. We were watching the Junior Miss pageant, which takes place in my hometown of Mobile, and never had a girl from Alabama won. And she came down to be one of the finalists, and we thought it was going to be too good to be true if she wins. She won. I called her up on the phone. I didn't think I'd even be able to reach her in that big auditorium. Finally got in touch with her, and I said, congratulations. We're so proud of you, Stephanie. Is there anything
I bring this to?
Yes, I'd like to meet President Reagan.
We're so pleased.
Hey,
well, thank you very much.
It's such an honor.
All right, first together to get prayer back in schools.
Yeah. We're all fine.
2 years of battling and we're going to be able to do
it. I appreciate your letter about the Equal Access Bill, which I'm sponsoring. They all mentioned it to 2 minutes that went out, and we'll do it. And
Mr. President, I have to bring the wire photographers and get a picture of the two of you.
Oh.
Thank you, sir.
And I see this proves that some days are better than others.
Okay.
Mississippi State.
Yes, sir.
I have to tell you, when I was a governor, they rise to the heights of Mississippi State with women. And out there, I was sitting in the Mississippi governor's box with him. And it was one of those moments in the game when it was very definite. Mississippi State was really taken over. And it was one of those moments when it was really silent. This whole stadium, this whole crowd silent for a moment. And about 14 rows back of us, I heard a voice say, man, if they do that for him, what would they have done if John Wayne was here? That's my memory of Mississippi.
And that was in Starkville?
Huh?
That was in Starkville, Mississippi?
I guess so, yeah. wherever the school is.
They didn't know who they had there, did they? If they didn't know you were there.
Well, yeah, because of the governor.
The governor
announced as being there and so forth.
But you weren't president then, were you?
No.
No, it was governor of California then, yeah.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
All right. So you open the day, they close the day. Beautiful. Like to introduce John Sam Roberts, Mr. President of the United States. He is the president of Kiwanis International. He's come from the Arab Day Convention in Vienna, Austria. He's delighted that Kiwanis International is now located in Indianapolis. Their headquarters.
Why don't we
surround it with this pitch team?
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes. I addressed you one of your national conventions.
In 1964, I was
yes.
there. Marvelous address.
Support of your jealousies.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Evelyn Cufflinks.
Oh, thank you. Hannah, so nice. But this was involved with your volunteerism, General. This is the.
Of course. Things of that kind. It is the most inspiring thing that has ever happened. I am hearing from all over the country of every kind of volunteer effort and what they do. And I think the topper is I have a letter on my desk from a little girl in fifth grade, a very well-written letter, and with it was a check for $187, which the fifth graders had raised and sent to help pay off the national debt. When I was in fifth grade, if you'd have said national debt, I wouldn't know what you were talking about.
That's awesome. Oh.
But it's just, it's spread them over.
Sweet story.
Indianapolis is quite a center for national, international headquarters.
Yes, it is.
My memory's trickling. Yeah, I think that's the headquarters of my fraternity, Tau Kappa Epsilon.
That's right. In fact,
very close to Kiwanis International.
We're out in what's called College Park area, which is where about 10 or 12 fraternities have their headquarters. Mm-hmm. American Legion headquarters are there in Indianapolis, too. We're actually from Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Used to be the headquarters of the Christian Church. Yes. I've lost track. That was my church. But I understand it's divided into about four. Yeah. Denominations now, and I don't know which one is which.
It used to be the fiddling and the non-fiddling, candlelights and all that were all part of the group.
Thank you, Mr. President.
We're grateful to you.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you. It's so nice to meet you again. Thank you so much.
Yeah, I'm a pretty good senator.
We're very proud of you.
We've had a good congressman from our area, too. Henson.
Mr. Ambassador, how do you do? Well.
Thank you, I'm fine. Very happy to see you, to meet you.
Well, pleased to meet you, Madam.
Hello,
nice to see you. I think they'd like is we'll do a picture over in front of the fireplace, and then we'll have you come in and we'll do one with all of us together. Welcome you again officially here.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I'm happy to be here in the country.
Now, could you?
Thank you.
Well, thank you.
Well, I hope you'll be very happy here and stay in Washington.
Thank you. Looks
up to you. It's a nice city. Pleasant city. Set down by the
well.
It's a nice place.
Yes. All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
President, may I present the Ambassador Perot?
Mr. President.
Mr. Ambassador.
It's a great honor for me.
Well, I am honored. And welcome back. I know you have.
I feel myself very. Very at home in Washington, D.C.
Yes.
Nice
my daughter,
you. Mr. President.
My sons, Raphael.
How do you do?
Mr. It is quite a pleasure and quite a privilege, Mr. President.
Well, we're pleased to have you. You and I will go over in front of the fireplace for a picture, and then you will all come in and join us.
Okay.
Good pleasure.
we've been very distressed at the terrible natural disasters that have befallen your country down there.
Unfortunately, we are facing very, very difficult moments. And also we have this problem of some infiltration of terrorism in my country, and which try to destroy in a strong democracy that we have.
I know.
But we are ready to fight for it.
We were sorry the president had to cancel his visit. We're hoping we can reschedule it.
I hope to, Mr. President, because I think that you both will be, do, we get along very adequately, you know. Mm-hmm. You have a very strong mind, a very strong position, you're quite a leader. And I think that my president is also quite a leader.
Well, thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you very much.
Won't you all come here, President?
How many are there?
We'll put you, I think, between us and be pretty good
picture.
Thank you.
I spent almost 5 years in Washington, D.C.
64, 69.
No, we're old. I have been here 20 years.
Well,
20 years.
He's a banker in New York, you know.
So.
I have to ask you directions. Coming from the West as I do.
I know, Mr. President, you have the heaviest game of. You have so many responsibilities, and this is for me quite a moment in my life, you know, and I'm going to remember it, and it's going to give me a great support to wait about. No?
Well, thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Mr. Ambassador.
Thank you, Mr. President.
We couldn't have known the way we were going to dress here.
You look very elegant.
Well,
Mr. President, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
A pleasure, Mr. President. Very, very nice.
Good to meet you. Mr. Ambassador, pleased to see you.
Mr. President.
Pleased to have you here. You and I will go in front of the fireplace for a picture, and then you will join us.
How kind. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
All right. And we can exchange our papers here and put this over there.
Thank you.
All right. Now, would you? Thank you. In the middle.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Well. Very pleased to have you here and right before 2 weeks. I know we've had a few arguments off and on here through these hectic months, but I choose to figure them that it's like a marriage. Every once in a while there are quarrels, but you still stay married.
Very much. Thank you very much, Mr.
And welcome. I hope your stay will be very happy here.
Thank you, Mr. President.
President, I represent the ambassador of the Seychelles.
Madam
Gossier.
Pleased to see you. And
I'm your husband, Roger Wilson, Mr. President. Yes. Nice to meet you.
Nice to see you. But you and I will go over here so we can have a picture taken, and then you'll come in and join us.
Thank you.
We're very pleased to have you here, and I hope you stay in the very You should be in the middle, I think. Be a prettier picture.
Yes, indeed.
Oh, I expect it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Look forward to continued good relations. There are problems of keeping the Indian Ocean open to navigation at all. Pleased to have you in Washington.
Thank you, Mr.
Thank you, President.
Continued cooperation and the maintenance of successful relations between our peoples.
Mm-hmm. Look forward to that. And I
know you've been representing your country at the UN for quite some time.
Well, Mr. President, I've been helping my wife, anyway, giving her some assistance at that. But I'm an attorney, and I practice law in Chicago. So we commute back and forth between Chicago and New York.
Well, I was
both born in Illinois.
I was misinformed when I saw my ambassador. I thought you were the ambassador to the UN.
Oh, no. No.
Not at all. I just got it wrong.
Ambassador Fitzpatrick is a very good friend. Very hard-working colleague.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Well, pleased to have you here.
Thank you.
This way.
The Ambassador of Luxembourg.
Yes, you're Ambassador the President. Pleased to have you here.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
Mr. President.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
May I introduce my daughter, and my son, Walter?
How do you do? Nice to see you.
So.
You and I will go over in front of the fireplace for a picture.
Right. Okay. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you
very much. It's a letter for this as a micro.
Yes. All right.
Thank you.
Well, we've had fine relations between our countries.
I hope they get better and better every day. I'll do my best to do so.
I know you will. And maybe we can persuade His Royal Highness to come for a state visit.
I think they are delighted to do so.
Well,
I just realized that it has been 20 years and their mother is very.